As the Shapella upgrades get close, we at Dappnode want to help you be ready for withdrawals. We're going to be presenting you with the easiest method available. However, if you want to try any alternate methods, we also put together a guide that talks about more options with different difficulty levels. First of all, it's important to notice that there are two types of withdrawals. Partial withdrawals, which consist of claiming your staking rewards, and full withdrawals, which consist of exiting your whole 32 ETH from your validator and stopping all validating activities. For a partial withdrawal, you're going to need a WadYukijin and your validator in the Beacon Chain Explorer. In case you're doing a full withdrawal, you're also going to need the Dappnode staking ring, but we'll get to that later. In the Beacon Chain Explorer, you should be able to see under deposits if you set up a withdrawal address when you first set up your validator. You can distinguish these because a withdrawal address ends with a 1, while a non-configured withdrawal address ends with a 0. The purpose of this example, we're going to use a validator in the Gerli testnet. So if you use an existing recovery phrase, you should be able to generate your BLS to execution change, which is also known as adding a withdrawal address. Make sure you disconnect from the internet while inputting your seed phrase. So the validator indexes are the numbers that appear in the top left part of the Beacon Chain Explorer. So then copy and paste it. And the BLS withdrawal credentials, which you can find under the tab withdrawal credentials. So we'll just copy this and add a wallet as a withdrawal address. Be aware that if you're adding addresses to multiple validators, you need to change your start index. And next we're gonna generate a JSON file. So let's go back to the Beacon Chain Explorer, and in the top right part, under More, click on Broadcast Sign Message. So here, you are gonna click the input area, and then select the BLS file that you just generated with YU. Okay, let's stop right there. Once you broadcast your signature, that's it, you're all set. Your withdrawal addresses have been uploaded to your validator. So from this point on, we're gonna be talking about how to do a full withdrawal. It's important that you do not proceed if you don't wanna stop validating duties. If you don't wanna withdraw your staked ETH, please stop right now. So we're gonna go to the packages and we're gonna look for the Web3 signer. In this case, we're gonna be using Prater because we're on Gerli. And we're going to visit the UI, which is going to take us to the staking brain. So under the staking brain, we're going to select the validators that we want to exit. And we're going to click on the exit validators button on the top right. It's going to ask for I want to exit. Type in confirmation. And once you click exit, you should be able to see it took me around 10 minutes, but you should be able to see this change under the Beacon Chain Explorer. So once you're able to see this update in the Beacon Chain Explorer, you should also be able to see the exit epoch when your validator will be able to leave the network and take your staked ETH.